morning students, today let us do exercise in the page number 188 and 189. The lesson name is adaptation in plants. So let us read the exercises. First one, it is here exercise 188 page number. Tick the correct answer. So here first one is a desert plant saves water by. A desert plant saves water by what? Here options are given. Not having leaves, growing in deserts, its stem making food. Which is the correct answer? A desert plant saves water by not having leaves. So already we had discussed this topic in the lesson what we learned in adaptation in plants. Desert plants save water by not having leaves. Okay, so the answer is first one, not having leaves. First answer is not having leaves. Now second one, plants growing in cold places have. Plants growing in cold places have. First one is no leaves, needle-like leaves. Second one, third one, broad leaves. Plants growing in cold places have. Which type of leaves they have? In cold places, they have the needle-like minute leaves. So here the answer is needle-like leaves. The answer is needle-like leaves. Means second one is the answer. Second question, second answer. Second question, the answer is second one. Plants growing in cold places have needle-like leaves. Next, this plant is grown in aquariums to keep the water clean. Third one, what is the third one? This plant is grown in aquariums to keep the water clean. First one is hydrilla, second one is lotus, third one is water lily. Which is the answer? The hydrilla is the answer. The plant grown in aquariums. Why the plant grown in aquariums is hydrilla? Because of it is underwater plant. So the aquarium contains water in it. So the plant which is inside the water here, hydrilla. Now the fourth question. Plants that grow on land are called. The plants that grow on land are called what? We have already discussed. Terrestrial plants. Now here it is given. First one is terrestrial plants. Second one is floating plants. Third one is aquatic plants. Plants that grown on land are called terrestrial plants. Here the fourth answer is number one. Next, mangroves are plants that grow in. Mangroves, which type of plants? Mangroves are which type of plants? Here asking. So first one is desert areas. They grow in desert areas. Second one, hilly areas. Third one, marshy areas. So already we had discussed the marshy area, sticky area grows. Mangrove plants grows in sticky area. That is called as marshy area. So here the answer is marshy area, last one. Third one, mangroves are plants that grow in marshy area. Now next one, B. Bit A we had already now finished. Okay, now bit B. Give two examples for each of the following. Give two examples for each of the following. First one, trees that grow in cold places. Trees that grow in cold places are kedar, pine and eucalyptus. Kedar, pine and eucalyptus. Next, second one, plants that grow in desert areas. Plants that grow in desert areas are the cactus, aloe vera, prickly pear, Okay. Second one, plants that grow in desert areas, cactus, aloe vera, prickly pear. Next, third one, plants that float on water. Plants that float on water are nothing but here, lotus, water lily. Plants that float on water, third one, plants that float on water, lotus and water lily. Next one, fourth one here, plants that are under water. Plants that are under water, Vallisneria, hydrilla. Vallisneria, hydrilla. Next, fifth one, plants that eat insects. Plants that eat insects, pitcher plant, Venus flytrap. Pitcher plant, Venus flytrap, sundew. Here, plants that eat insects, sundew, pitcher plant, Venus flytrap. Plants that eat insects, sundew, pitcher plant, Venus flytrap. Okay, now plants that are under water, Vallisneria, hydrilla. Plants that are under water, Vallisneria, hydrilla. Plants that float on water, water lily, lotus. Plants that float on water, water lily, lotus. Okay. Again, here one more question is, plants that grow in desert areas, prickly pear, cactus, date palm, aloe vera. Prickly pear, cactus, date palm and aloe vera. Okay, now let us go to the third bit, nothing but question and answers. Answer the following questions. Third bit, answer the following questions. Here, what are the special features of desert plants? First one is what are the special features of desert plants? So, what are the special features of desert plants? This question, where is the answer in the textbook? Let us search that one. Now, go to the topic here, desert plants. So now, here, this is the paragraph of desert plants. Here, you have to write the first question answer from here onwards. The paragraph, page number 186, second paragraph, in this second line, middle onwards, the plants that grow in desert are called xerophytes. Many of these plants do not have leaves. As water is not easily found in deserts, they should not lose water. Not having leaves is a way of saving water. These plants have thick green fleshy stems which can prepare and store food. Date palm, cactus, prickly pear plants are some of the common desert plants. Now the answer is, first answer is the plants onwards to the last. Full stop. Okay, first answer is finished now. Now come to the second question. What is the second question? Let us see. Why do tea plants grow on hill slopes? Why do tea plants grow on hill slopes? Now come to the topic. Here same page number 186, page number, the first paragraph. Here tea plants grow in hilly areas. The water requirement of these plants is very peculiar. Okay, they need plenty of water and at the same time water should not stagnate near the roots. So they grow on hill slopes where water keeps flowing down. The Nilgiris, Darjeeling are
for the gardens. Up to here, total paragraph you have to write. So here, first answer finished, second answer finished. Means first answer here already I showed. Here the second paragraph in 186 page number middle onwards. Okay, here to last. Okay, last. Next, again come to the second question. Total paragraph, this paragraph you have to write. Okay, next. What about the third question? Let us see. What are breathing roots? Name two plants that with breathing roots. What are the breathing roots? Name two plants. Okay, here come to the page number 1 means the lesson, first lesson in adaptations, in the adaptations in plant lesson, first page number, that means 185 page number. Here you have to come to the third paragraph. First one finished, here to here, second one finished, third one. Here in marshy areas, marshy means what? Sticky, sticky clay area. The soil is sticky and clay like. In such areas, plants' roots do not get enough air. So a special type of roots called breathing roots come out and grow above the soil. Okay, the trees that grow in marshy areas are called mangroves. Okay, Avicennia and Rhizophora have breathing roots. These are the examples of this marshy area plants, mangrove plants. Examples are Avicennia, Rhizophora. Okay, now you have to write this paragraph, third paragraph. Okay, for your answer, third question answer. Okay, finished. Now let us go to the fourth question. What are the specialties of the leaves of aquatic plants? What are the specialties of the leaves of the aquatic plants? Here we have to learn one thing here. Aquatic plants are different types. So here we can say that the floating plants, underwater plants and fixed plants. Three types of plants are there here. So here we can say here, first one here, see, leaves of aquatic plants are covered with wax. This is page number 187, fourth question, 187 page number. Aquatic plants, plants that grow in water are called aquatic plants. The leaves of aquatic plants are covered with wax. This one you have to write. In which page number? 187 page number. First line onwards to the second line starting wax. Up to here you have to write. Okay, then turn the page now. Same answer. Continuation. Turn the page now. Here now page number is 188. Now here come to the first paragraph. Here second line, first paragraph, second line, the leaves are ribbon like and have no stomata in underwater plants. So now here you have to write, plants that grow under water have, otherwise I will write the answer, fourth answer on the board. Now fourth answer I wrote on the board. Okay, now I will read once more. The question is, what are the specialities of the leaves of aquatic plants? What are the specialities of the leaves of aquatic plants? Now here, plants that grow in water are called aquatic plants, that you know. But here now, aquatic plants, the leaves of aquatic plants are covered with wax. Already we have discussed in the class that I have taught. of the leaves. But in underwater plants, the leaves do not have the stomata. They do not have stomata. Stomata means what? They are just like nose to the plant. Okay, nose. So the plants exchange the gases through the stomata. They take in carbon dioxide, they give out oxygen. They take in carbon dioxide, they give out oxygen. Okay, these are the question answers of the adaptation in plants lesson. Okay, this is finished now. Here activity. So examine the plants growing in different places. Now note down their specialties. Just observe the plants in your area, in nearby your house, at your home. Observe and write down in your notes whether they are terrestrial plants or aquatic plants or desert plants. That quality you have to write in your fair notes. And again here already I have given you the question and answers and the exercises, that all you have to write in your fair notes. Every bit you have to write in your fair notes. Okay, sow some seeds in a pot. Note the different stages of their growth. So now take some seeds and take one pot and add some soil in it and sow some seeds. Okay, in it. Now pour water. Sprinkle water on it morning and evening. Okay, after 4 days you observe what will happen. Okay, then after little bit growth of the plants, you have to observe that one, what is the development going on in the plant. Okay. Okay, today's topic is finished. Okay, we'll meet in next class.